I'm Shirish and today we are going to talk about how to discipline children. Imagine you have been to a public event or some public place wherein somebody has appreciated your child about his way of speaking, his respect to elders or taking care of his younger sibling. You feel so great, so there is so much of pride for a parent. But at the same time, you feel bad if somebody says, see how stubborn the kid is, see he doesn't behave properly at all or he doesn't have good manners. It really hurts every parent. So today we are going to discuss about how to take care of the children, how to discipline them. Okay, now discipline is something, of course, we need to discipline the child from the very beginning of his understanding, but it is never late. The very first thing that we need to understand about discipline is that you need to give attention to the child. When the child seeks some time from you, some advice from you, or if he comes to share something with you, do you give him that undivided time? I understand today's parents are working, they have less time, but when the child approaches you, do you give your child the undivided time? I mean, when we talk with our children, we always have that mobile in our hands. Or we have laptops in front of us, like regarding some work thing we are scheduling or discussing or have a video conferences and all. So do we give that undivided time to the child? No. So that is what makes the child feel that he is less important, and because of which the child at times becomes stubborn and adamant. So to avoid this, to make the child understand that he is important for us rather than anything else, or just make him feel good, you need to keep everything that you are doing aside for some time so that the child feels good and his confidence increases. Okay, in this case, the child really will not ever become stubborn, or he would not react in a very negative way to anything that you say. Okay, here the child becomes more acceptable to what his parents say. Second is, we need to understand that the child observes us. Okay, in case of disciplining the child observes us in every manner, everything that we do. Now, if the parents, they themselves have a work schedule, a schedule that even they even follow when they're at home, like on Sundays also, if you have the habit of getting up early in the morning, having your breakfast, then exercise, if that is something you always do, the child is something who will also have a structured or a disciplined day. Okay, so for the child to follow all those things, you need to follow your discipline, your structure, day structure as well. Punctuality. If you follow your timings, your schedule strictly, if you are going to office at 9 o'clock, you're leaving the home at 8:30, the child will also understand that he needs to leave the house before 15-20 minutes so that he reaches his place in time. Or when you come back from the office, how do you keep your clothes? How do you keep your shoes? Where do you keep your bag? This is something which is a very important part of discipline. These small things all together make a person a disciplined person. So if you are coming back from office, throwing your bag somewhere, throwing your shoes and socks at some place, and removing your shirt and keeping it on the bed itself, so that is not something that we are expecting from the child, right? So similarly, when you are back from your office, you also need to take care of it, that you are removing your shirt properly and hanging it on the hanger, keeping the shoes back into the shoe rack, and keeping your tiffins or your bags in some fixed place. So that is something disciplines the child as well. If you have a proper schedule for your lunch or dinner, and you are giving your 100% on that table as well. Like many parents have a habit of roaming around and eating. They have a habit of hanging on their phone and eating, talking to someone continuously on the phone and eating. So that is something which makes the child understand that this work is not important. Having food with the family, sharing, talking, it's also one of very important things that the child needs to pick up from us. But if we are busy on our phones or we are continuously talking to someone, the child obviously picks up this habit. And there his discipline of having food properly, sitting at one place, breaks. Okay. Similarly, talking to elders. The child learns from us how we talk to our elders, how we pay respects to them, or how we greet them. Like if we have the habit of greeting everybody in the morning at home, when you get up in the morning, if you're greeting everybody good morning, the child also will start reciprocating the same. If you have a habit of paying respect to your elders by bowing in front of them or even greeting them, the child will also pick that up. Okay, or in typical Marathi families, we have that at 7 o'clock when we go to light the diya in front of God, we have some prayers to say, or praying habits you can say. So if you are following it as a mother, as a parent, the child follows it. So discipline is nothing but inculcating all these small habits to the children, which makes him a good personality, which reflects a good behavior, and the child thus becomes a well-disciplined person. Okay, so to inculcate all these habits, we are the concerned person who need to take care of all these things. Now, second one important thing is also that we all need at home, the way we speak at home, the way we speak in the office, the way we speak on phone with friends is something our child always observes us. Okay, so we need to be very conscious and very particular about the language we use with the child or with our friends whom the child is listening to. One more thing is when at times it happens that we at times choose to lie, maybe to our friends or to our bosses, when we do not want to work or don't want to go to office, we have our own problems and which makes us lie. But the child understands that his parent has lied, and he doesn't understand the difference between the lies and telling the truth. He doesn't understand what is good and what is bad. But if his parent is doing something, the child understands it is a good way to do. It is a good way to get rid of, and he very easily picks up that habit. So see, if you need to lie, you please go ahead, but do it somewhere which is not in front of your child. Do it away from your child's side so that he doesn't pick that bad habit. Okay, so disciplining a child is not a difficult task. We can definitely do it in some elder age, thode bachche bade ho jane ke baad. It takes time, it may take time, but yes, definitely you need to give it some time. But if you start it from the very beginning, the children grow up as a disciplined child. Okay, so I think these are some tips which I shared, and that will definitely help you to discipline your child. Do let me know how you like it, or how were you able to inculcate in this things in your child's day-to-day activities. Thank you so much. If you have liked my videos so far, do please like them and subscribe my channel so that you get more updates on the parenting tips which we would be further going and doing ahead. Thank you.